Hi everybody, today is April 13th, 2013. Kind of makes me mad, but it's not surprising. Then I have to laugh that you gotta find out what's going on here in the United States on a foreign news service. This comes from Australia. Huge landslides shuts Kennecock, Utah, Copper's Bingham Canyon mine. Vast landslide was a couple of thousand feet wide and tall. The slide covered about two-thirds of the bottom of the pit. And they have an image here of that huge slide. Look at that. The world's largest man-made excavation, a U.S. copper mine, has been shut down by an enormous landslide that smashed roads and buildings and left two-thirds of the pit base buried. And thank God no one was hurt in the collapse at the massive open-cast Bingham Canyon mine run by Rio Tinto owner Kennecock, Utah Copper. Largely because the workers had been evacuated amid several weeks of warning signs the ground was going to shift. We started noticing movement in that part of the mine in February, said Rio Tinto Kennecock spokesman Kyle Bennett, according to the Salt Lake City Tribune. He said the indications were that the mine's wall was slipping a millimeter or so every day. The mine monitors for movement at all times. Another website has several images. It says mining operations have been suspended indefinitely as geologists assess the stability. Here it looks half the building went with it. But by Wednesday morning, local time, mine engineers started seeing movement at up to 5 centimeters per day and moved out the 37 workers at the bottom of the vast open mine. The company has also warned residents nearby that a slide was possible any day. At 11 a.m. yesterday, we moved everyone out, including those who were working in the bottom of the mine, Bennett said. All of our employees are safe and accounted for. Bingham Canyon Mine is the largest man-made excavation in the world. It has been in production since 1906 and features a pit almost 1 kilometer deep and 4 kilometers wide. This is something we had anticipated, Bennett told the Deseret News. We knew the slide was imminent. We had relocated machinery, we had rerouted roads, we had rerouted utilities, we had rerouted buildings. Ted Himmelbaugh, Kennecock's general manager of operation readiness, said he had seen nothing like this in his 36 years with the company. Our primary goal now is to determine how we can safely resume operations and provide not only the jobs for the people, but money to the state of Utah and economy. Hinnenbaugh told the Deseret News. Now you notice it's not a big name news corporation, it's a small paper. Kennecock is the second largest copper producer in the U.S., supplying about a quarter of the country's copper, the company website states. So this is going to have a huge impact, I would think, on the cost of copper. They use copper in wiring and a lot of different things. A third of the U.S. copper coming from this mine, and it's not on the news. You got to hear about it from Australia. Pretty bad. All right, bookmark my site. I'll keep you up to date. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.